Hey everybody, and welcome back to another exciting episode of 7-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn tips, tricks, and shortcuts in 7 minutes or less. No BS, just AE. This is part 2 of a 3-part series I'm doing on text animators. Now, if you haven't seen the previous episode on how to use the Scale Text Animator, I highly recommend you do that now or after you watch this episode. It's not necessary for you to understand the concepts we'll be going over in this episode, but it will give you a more well-rounded understanding of how these text animators can work together. In this episode, we'll be creating our own custom text animation using Fill RGB Color, Fill RGB Hue, and Opacity text animators. Now, if you're not familiar with these, stay tuned. After this tutorial, you'll be creating your own custom text animations within 7 minutes. Even if you are familiar with these text animators, stick around. You may just learn something new that you can incorporate into other animations. This episode is sponsored by the good people over at Envato Elements. Check them out by following the link in the description below and get an amazing 70% discount off your first month. Just make sure to tell them Jeff Knight sent you. Before we get into today's tutorial, let's check out Envato Elements. I want to thank Envato Elements for sponsoring this episode, and also thank my viewers for making this sponsorship possible. For designers, editors, and animators, Envato Elements is an amazing resource. With your membership, you can download unlimited assets for anything you could possibly want or need for your projects. Get access to high-res stock videos and photos, as well as motion graphic templates for titles, video displays, logo animations, lower thirds, infographics, promos, openers, and so much more. You also get access to backgrounds, textures, patterns, and icons, which we all know are vital resources. Download thousands of font styles and perfect one for your project quickly with their easy-to-use filtering system. You get access to music for your sound beds and virtually any style or genre you can possibly imagine for designing the perfect sound for your projects. Speaking of sound design, you have access to Envato Elements' entire sound effects database, which includes any sound you could possibly need or want for anything from short film production to commercials to logo stingers. There are also resume, portfolio, and web templates to help you land that perfect motion graphics job, or to show your clients your work in a modern, professional, and impressive way. Every asset comes with commercial and non-commercial licensing at no extra cost, so both you and your clients can produce amazing projects with peace of mind. And again, with your membership, you get unlimited downloads of all of these assets from Envato Elements. Download as much as you want, as often as you want, without ever having to pay for individual projects or files. Check out Envato Elements from the link in the description below and get 70% off the first month. That means you have access to everything from Envato Elements for less than $10. It's an unbelievable deal, and I highly recommend you check it out. Please like this video so I can make that YouTube algorithm happy. Share this video and our channel with your fellow motion graphic designers so they can become After Effects rock stars just like us. And click the bell so that way you're notified every time I upload a new tutorial. And please, leave me a message in the comments below and tell me what you thought about this episode. Sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's a comprehensive course that covers literally every aspect of shape layers, and it's guaranteed to make you a shape layer wizard. The link to that course, to the 70% discount from Envato Elements, the presets we're creating, and the project files for this text animation series are all in the description below. I've also included a table of contents so you can go back and rewatch sections that you found difficult. Okay, there's a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. Just want to show you how you can do some pretty cool things with a couple of text animators, and you can save these as presets so that way you can bring them in future projects. The way all of these work is you're going to be pulling in some text animators from this animate arrow right here. So click on that. We want to add in fill color RGB. Just rename this animator to color and make sure that you have color highlighted, and let's add in a fill color hue. The reason why I say that is this. If you notice under our color tab now, we have fill color and hue. I'm going to back out of that. If I just have text highlighted and I go and add fill color hue, we get a whole other text animator. So I really want these to work together. So just keep in mind the way that you stack these is going to affect your final animation. To get the look we're going for, let's highlight color and we're going to add back in that fill color hue. And then let's alt click on fill hue. I'm going to type in an expression. We'll say time times 1000. And this is going to change the hue of our fill color over time. So if we watch that play back, we see how it goes really, really fast. Okay, so now let's open up our range selector here. Open up the advanced tab. So now remember the animation whenever we use our offset for this square setting is 0%. And I'm going to go forward about 20 frames and move up to 100%. This color animates, and then one by one, the characters become our original color. Because remember, our original text color was white. So we get the original values once our text animation has completed. So now see, this isn't really all that interesting. I'm gonna do a few more things of this. So we're gonna go back down here to randomize order and click that on. I'm just gonna loop this. And as we can see, we get something a little bit more interesting. Maybe we'll make this animation last a little bit longer. So we get this blinking colors, but they're all the same color if you notice. So like you stop anywhere in here, you see that we kind of get the same colors. Well, I wanna get these colors to be randomized. So the way you do that is just change your shape from square to ramp up. So see, now you get variations of that hue. It's not quite the animation we want, and that's because with ramp up, our offset is going to be negative 100 to 100%. So at 100%, we get our original value of white for our text, and at negative 100%, we get this color red. And in between, we get the various hues on each color. Watch that play back. Just going to spread this out a little bit more. So now I want these characters to fade in. So instead of starting off all red, I want them to kind of fade in and we get something that looks a little bit better. So the way we do that is click on text and we're gonna add an opacity text animator. So now remember the opacity of our layer is already set to 100%. Change this to opacity. So whenever I animate our opacity, the final animation will be our original layer opacity value. So I'm gonna change this down to 0 and then let's open up our range selector, advanced, and then we have our square setting, so let's change that to ramp up. And then we want to change our offset value. Remember, it's negative 100 to begin. Go forward maybe about 20 frames and change this to 100%. So now if we watch this, we get something that looks kind of like that. And again, not exactly what we're looking for, but the reason why is because we need to set randomize order to on. Spread this out, which is really more what I'm kind of going for. And now if we do change this back to square and make this initial value 0, we can see how it's going to affect our animation differently. So watch it back. The letters just kind of pop on one at a time. So depending on what you're going for, if you want to just pop on one at a time, or if you want it to be a little bit more gradual, you can use ramp up, change that value to negative 100, and we see how it looks different. So now I'm still kind of getting this at the beginning where a lot of these colors are the same hue. So I'm just gonna hide this opacity one right now. So that way we have the full color. So if you wanna change these colors, make this initial value, maybe like negative 50. So that way the animation is already kind of starting. So see how these colors start to mix a little bit quicker. And if we turn back on our opacity text animator, by the time it animates in, we're already kind of having some of these other color values come in. And now I want this to not fade out quite as much. Let's go back up to our color settings and maybe increase our ease high more. So that way it eases in more to the final setting. So you can see the difference of that with ease high set to 100%. We get those colors for a little bit longer. Whereas we've had it set to 0, they fade out a little bit quicker. Now we can go back to our opacity text animator and we can change the randomized order. We can turn that off. So it comes on from left to right, if that's what you're going for. Or we can put it back to on and maybe we want it to come on words instead. So now it's going to animate on one word at a time, but the colors will animate by character. I like to keep my based on consistent throughout. So I'm going to turn this back to characters. The cool thing about this animation is, let's close these up. If we hide this color animator here, now we have a pretty cool opacity animator. So maybe you just want to animate the opacity. I'm going to take these keyframes and kind of play with this a little bit. And let's even play with our advanced settings even more. Turn that up to 100%. Maybe want something quicker. And again, you can change this to words. So it comes on one word at a time, randomly, because we have it set to randomize order, or one line at a time randomly. Again, we'll change this back to characters and this is our final animation. If we add back in our color, we now have our opacity with our color animation. You can save these as presets. Just highlight text and transform, animation, save animation preset. Now in the previous episode, I mentioned that whenever you save animation presets, you want to make sure that you save them to documents, Adobe, the version you're using, user presets, and then either drop them in that folder or create one. We created a folder called 7-Minute Text Animators. Now, if you're creating several of these text animators in one editing session, After Effects will take you to the last folder you saved a preset to. When we chose Save Animation Preset, notice that it brought us directly to the 7-Minute Text Animator folder, which is the last place I saved a text animator to. So we can call this Color Opacity Animation. And if we go back into our animation presets, go back to user presets, I'm going to open up the 7-Minute Text Animators. Here we have our color animator opacity. Open up our text here and get rid of these two text animators. So we have our original text. Double click on color opacity animation and we see that this did save. It's just a cool way to kind of play with some of these text animators using the fill color and fill hue text animators. One thing that's kind of cool about these text animators too, I'm just going to get rid of this entire layer. Now watch, if I just double click on this with nothing in my timeline, it will bring back in the text that we originally typed. So that's kind of cool too. To bring them in, you don't have to even actually apply them to a text layer. Now, you may want to go ahead and have your text set so that way you know what you're going to be animating and you sort all of that out before you start to animate. But you can always just bring this in by double clicking in your user presets and it will bring in the text that was used to save the original text animation preset. I hope this tutorial helped you out. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe. And click the bell so that way you're notified every time I put up a new tutorial. Please share this video and our channel with your fellow motion graphic designers so they can become After Effects rock stars just like us. And please, leave me a message in the comments below and let me know what you thought about this episode. Come back next week for part 3 of this 3-part series on how to use text animators. If you haven't seen the previous episode on how to use the Scale Text Animator, I highly recommend you do that right now. Sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's a comprehensive course that covers literally every aspect of shape layers and is guaranteed to make you a shape layer master. The link to that course, to the 70% discount from Envato Elements, the presets we're creating, and the project files for this 3-part series are all in the description below. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.